we talk about inventory tracking, we're usually dealing with one of two different types of scenarios. The first scenario is what we call a direct item tracking. And a good example of that would be something from our previous menu that we've programmed here. Let's say one of our bagels. So if we're buying a bagel and we're selling a bagel, we might be using different units to purchase. We might be purchasing in a case and selling in a single unit, but we're not really doing anything to modify that product from the time that we buy it to the time that we sell it, except maybe to throw it in an oven and heat it up. So in that case, that would be a direct item tracking. We're going to track inventory directly on that item. So let's first just go to Manager, and we're going to go to Administrative and Inventory Maintenance here so that we can have just a quick look at our bagel. So I'm going to search for it and pull up our plain bagel. That's the one that we're going to track for now. And one of the first things we want to talk about here is that in order to start tracking items and depleting inventory levels and adding to inventory levels, we need to come find the Count This Item checkbox that we've disabled for most of the items in our menu already, and we need to check that box. Now this allows us to add to and deplete this item from inventory when we're making sales. So let's go ahead and save this change to the item, and what we really need to do is back up for just a few moments here and let's create a vendor. We have to have vendors if we're going to track inventory and issue purchase orders and receive purchase orders. We've definitely got to set that up first. So vendor maintenance is where we're going, and we're going to get there by clicking on number 5 administrative from our categories and finding letter G for vendor maintenance. This is our vendor maintenance screen, and we have one example vendor in the system already. And very similar to department item maintenance, we have a next and a previous button that would let us navigate through a list of vendors. We also have this drop-down that would drop down a list of vendors if we had more than one as well. And we're going to go ahead and just click add, and we're going to make a bagel vendor. Now, very similar also to the item number and the description, the vendor number is going to be an abbreviated, very short description of the vendor, and the company name is going to be a longer description. So let's go ahead and make this Bagel Vendor Inc. Just for example, this is our company name, and we're going to click save. It's going to ask us if we want to create some additional vendors, but we're going to decline that for now. What we can see now is that the drop-down does show a couple of different vendors here. If we want to go back and add things such as the street address, which will come in handy later, then we could do so. Now, once that's done, we're going to exit out of the vendor maintenance, and we're going to actually go back to our inventory maintenance screen and look up that bagel again. Let's find our plain bagel. That's the one that we're interested in dealing with for the moment. And I'm going to select it so that we can actually look at the record for this item and we can modify this record. What we're going to be focusing on, obviously we're going to make sure that we did check the Count This Item box so that we can deplete inventory. And we're going to go to the Ordering Info tab here for the item. Now right now it's set up on the example vendor, but that's not really what we're trying to do. So I'm going to remove the pricing from this vendor. It's going to remove the association of the bagel with that vendor. And in its place, what we're going to do is we're going to add our new vendor that we just created, Bagels Inc. So let's just click that vendor. And it's always going to ask us if there's a vendor part number. As long as the item number is something that your vendor is going to recognize, we don't need to put another vendor part number here. This is just an additional item number that in some cases a merchant might need in order to communicate with the vendor what the item really is. And now that we have the vendor associated with the item, we need to consider what is our smallest unit of measure, the smallest unit that we're going to be handling these bagels in. And that unit is going to be a single bagel. And we also need to understand what is the unit that we're actually going to be purchasing these in bulk. And if those are different units, then this plays into how we set up the item. So for our example here, we're going to say that we buy these bagels from Bagel Vendor Inc. and we're going to buy them in a case of 30 at a time, and we're going to sell them in a single unit each. So in order to set the reorder level and the reorder quantity up, this would be the first thing that we would want to do. And what these pieces are, these are the key pieces that allow us to track how low we get in inventory and how much we need to reorder. The reorder level is really how many we have in stock And what that point is, it's going to trigger us to do the reorder. So if we wanted to say that we buy these by the case of 30, and when we get down to our very last case, we need to order two more cases. Let's take that for our example. Then what we're going to do here is we're actually going to input not the case quantity, but the number of single units that's going to trigger this reorder. In this case, we're going to use 30 units because that is going to be one case when we get down to that level, and that's going to trigger a reorder. Now, if we want to reorder two additional cases when we hit that low limit, then we're going to actually multiply two times the number per case. So we're going to say that we need to reorder 60 units, which is two cases. And that's how we set up our reorder quantity. That's going to be when we have our trigger here for the reorder level, the reorder quantity is going to be how many we're reordering to get us back up to a safe level in stock. Now, whenever we're ordering this way, where we're buying and selling, we're tracking this actual direct unit here, we do need to go ahead and think about setting up what we call the case relationship down here below. We've got a cost per, which is a cost for a single unit, and let's say that that's $1. And then we're going to have a case cost. So let's say if it's a cost per, there's 30 per case, then our case cost is going to be $30 exactly. And then it's going to want to know the relationship, how many are in a case, and we're going to set that to 30 because that's our relationship. And before we go on, the next piece that we need to do is we need to go ahead and put our initial physical count in, the number in stock for the bagels. So in order to do that, we're going to use the instant PO feature here, and this allows us to add inventory. And what we're going to do is it's going to ask us for a description. Let's go ahead and put in physical count. We can really put anything in here. This is just a little bit of a text description that we'll be able to review later. So let's click enter here to move on, and it's going to ask us for how many we received. Now let's go ahead and start out with 30 in stock. That's 30 bagels or one case. Click OK. And now you can see that field that was grayed out that we couldn't change any other way. It's actually changed now for us to the 30 in stock to begin our sales. Next, we can exit out of the inventory maintenance screen, and we want to actually sell this item a few times and watch how the inventory is depleted on the item. So let's sell three plain bagels. Let's go ahead and cash them out. And we're going to go back into Manager, Administrative Inventory Maintenance, and we're going to look up our bagel again. We want to see how the inventory stock levels have changed. Now you'll notice here that right on the lookup screen, we have access to view stock levels on our items. And this is really nice and handy. It allows us to point right to the plain bagel and see that we had 30, we sold 3, that means we have 27 left. If we want to double click or select the item, we can go back in and see that that 27 is also what it really is the number in stock here that's grayed out. This is being depleted as we're making sales.